Well, hello guys, it's Chris. From inheriting an unexpected artifact to mysteries from the universe, here are 9 unexpected and rare discoveries. Number 9. The discovery of microwaves. You might look at something like the humble microwave and think that this was something thought about years before its creation. I mean, we all have microwaves, right? It's hard to imagine life without them. But their invention wasn't as predictable as you might think. Not unlike various other discoveries, the idea of the microwave was discovered quite by accident by a man named Percy Spencer. In 1946, Percy Spencer was contracted by the Raytheon Corporation to work on a project related to radar, something that was big at this time because of World War II. While working on a vacuum tube, he noticed something wrong with his pocket. Mainly, the chocolate bar that was in it was fully melted, which shouldn't have been possible in the time it was there. Realizing that the only way this was possible was via the tube, he pointed it at other food objects and watched as they all got heated and cooked. Seeing this, he realized that they were being cooked by microwaves. And later on, he filed a patent for the first microwave oven machine. By the time 1965 came around, the first countertop microwave was released. And all of this started with a melted chocolate bar. Ta-da! Chocolate solves everything. Number 8. The liver jar. We've all had those family heirlooms and gifts that we never quite understood or appreciated until much later on in our lives, for one reason or another. In the case of one average family, they inherited a piece of stone from an uncle who had died. Not wanting to disrespect his will and wishes, they kept the stone and put it in various places in the house or in the garden. Eventually, someone decided to actually take a look at the stone. When they did, they noticed that the face and headset of the stone was Egyptian-like. Wondering what it could mean, they took it for granted. Turns out that uncle had given them a very rare Egyptian artifact, one that was 3,000 years old and was actually a liver jar. Though thankfully for the family and scientists, there wasn't an actual liver in the jar, it was empty. Although maybe the scientists were disappointed. While this may sound odd and a little disgusting, this was actually a very common part of Egyptian culture. The bodies of various people would have their organs removed and put in jars, such as the heirlooms the family had. The belief was that the dead would eventually come back for the organs once they made it into the afterlife. The heirloom was actually modeled after the god king known as Imseti, who had the duty of guarding said livers and organs until the dead reclaimed them. On a personal note, could you imagine what would have happened if the family opened a jar and saw a liver inside? So gross, I'm just saying. Number 7. Penicillin. Sometimes it's the most accidental of discoveries that change the world forever. And that's exactly why penicillin is one of the most unexpected discoveries of all time. For while we can't imagine our world without it now, the life-saving medicine wasn't actually discovered until 1928 by a man named Alexander Fleming. Fleming was a biologist out of Scotland, and his day job was investigating staph. After a long time of working, Fleming decided to take a vacation and left his lab exactly how it was when he was done working. Upon returning to the lab, he noticed that there was a weird fungus growing on a culture. Further examination revealed that the fungus had actually killed every single bacteria that was within its reach. Knowing he was onto something, he then grew the fungus on his own, intentionally this time, and realized that this could have many uses. Weirdly, people weren't interested in penicillin when he created it, but after years of tests and papers, it slowly started to be used on animals and humans, and numerous issues were found to be cured by it. Today, penicillin is one of the most important basic medicines in the world, and a lot of people would be sick or dead if it hadn't been for this unexpected discovery. And now for number 6, but if you're new to World List, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on any of the latest videos. Number 6. Cargo ship from 1773. During the construction of One World Trade Center in New York City in the United States, the workers had to dig pretty deep to start on what is now an underground parking lot as well as a security center. When they got 20 feet down, they found something very odd. A cargo ship. One that, based on its construction and materials, was actually pretty old. Like, a few centuries old. So how did a cargo ship get under the ground of the original World Trade Center? In 2014, scientists examined the wood that made up the ship and determined that it came from Philadelphia in 1773. As for how it got underground, it made its final resting place in Lower Manhattan. And when the New York Harbor shoreline crept closer and closer to it, the ship slowly got buried by trash and landfill. Until finally, at around 1818, the ship was buried from sight, and it was only found after the tragedy of 9/11. Number 5. X-rays. Now a common medical procedure, back in 1895, the idea of X-rays weren't even on the minds of doctors and scientists the world over. Then one day, a German physicist named Wilhelm Röntgen did an experiment that led to very unexpected results. He was working on a cathode ray tube and noticed that he could see an image. This was odd, as the tube itself was completely covered, yet it was showing on a fluorescent screen nearby when the room was pitch black. Curious, he tried to block the glow that was showing up on the screen, including putting his hand in front of the tube to try and block it. When he did, he saw an image of his bones within his hand on the screen. Understanding, sort of in part, what was going on, he swapped the tube for a photographic plate. Thus, X-ray imagery was born. The only real catch was that at first, doctors and such didn't exactly know that X-rays were harmful to people. But hey, it had to be discovered first before realizing the dangers, right? Number 4. The Ding Bowl. Don't you just love yard sales? Sometimes you'll go there and find a perfectly priced item, or something from your childhood that you want to reconnect with, and sometimes you find an ancient Chinese artifact. No, seriously, that's exactly what happened back in 2007. A family went to a yard sale and saw a white bowl for sale. It was basic, but they liked it, and they bought it for $3. Happy with the purchase, they showed it off at their house until one day they decided to learn about the bowl's origins. What they would realize very soon, and certainly made their jaws drop, was that they were in possession of a 1,000-year-old Ding bowl, and it was worth around $300,000. So why was it worth that much? Well, it traced back to the Northern Song Dynasty, and was actually one of their best examples of the ceramics they made. Plus, the family and the family before them took pretty good care of it, so it was in great condition. But wait, there's one more unexpected twist here. You see, knowing that they had a valuable item, the family put it up for auction. And instead of getting $300,000 like they were told it's worth, a bidding war took it up to $2.2 million. All for a $3 bowl they got at a yard sale. Number 3. The Big Bang Theory. So this is a story about two nerd roommates and a blonde girl that moves in next to them. Hey, wait. What's that? Oh, wrong Big Bang Theory? My bad. Okay, this is about the literal Big Bang Theory, which had to be discovered and technically proven. It all started with Robert Wilson and Arno Penzias, who were radio astronomers. They would listen to the stars above and see what signals they could pick up. During a test of the Homedale antenna, which is in New Jersey, the duo heard a sound they just couldn't explain. They went through all the likely suspects, but didn't figure out what was going on. Then they found out about a theory from a professor named Robert Dickey, who theorized that radiation from a universe-creating event could still exist today as background cosmic radiation. Sure enough, this is what Wilson and Penzias found. And after detailing what they had discovered, the Big Bang Theory, one of the most prevailing theories about our existence in the universe, was officially born. For their efforts in proving this, the two won a Nobel Prize. Number 2. The Peacemaker. It's a fact of life that everyone has a heart, but that doesn't mean that they all act the same ways. And there are plenty of diseases and conditions that can cause the heart to beat irregularly and quite painfully for the host. So thus, the pacemaker is a valuable tool, as it's able to stimulate the heart into beating regularly. But none of this would have been possible without a wrong resistor. Confused? Well, this has to do with a man named Wilson Greatbatch, who was actually trying to build a machine to record the sounds of a heartbeat. He needed a resistor to finish his machine, but he got the wrong one out of his toolbox. Not realizing it, he finished the machine and noticed that it started to emit electrical impulses, ones that made kind of a heartbeat. Funnily enough, Greatbatch had thought about the concept of a pacemaker in the past, but he didn't think it was possible. Well, until then, he went to work on making a smaller version of the device. And by May 7th, 1958, the first pacemaker was officially put into a dog, and the rest is history. Number 1. Safety glass for windshields. Anyone who drives a car knows that the windshield that's in front of them, and to the side and back of them, is designed to break, but not shatter. This is a defense mechanism that helps keep people safe in their cars. But what we have now was at one time unknown, until Edward Benedictus dropped a beaker back in 1903. You see, he was doing an experiment. One involving cellulose nitrate, which some of you may recognize as a kind of liquid plastic. Anyways, while doing the experiment, Edward dropped his beaker, and it broke on the ground. But though it broke, it didn't shatter into a million pieces like a beaker of the time should have. So what happened? Well, the cellulose nitrate actually interacted with the glass in such a way that it prevented it from shattering. After more experiments, Edward Benedictus helped create safety glass, which is now something we use in not just windshields, but also safety goggles and various other objects and materials to try and prevent shattering. Well, thanks for watching, guys. Can you believe these unexpected discoveries? Which one is your favorite? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on World List.